I feel incredibly blessed with two beautiful boys, and they, you know, were wonderful when I had them, perfect in every way. And when I had George, he was about 4 months old, and things started to change. He developed, I can't start talking about it. He was 4 months old, and I didn't take him until he developed a rash, and he was 10 months old when I took him, because I didn't know what it was. I took him to the pediatrician. I was putting petroleum jelly on his face and antibiotics on his face because he was so rashed up and so infected, till I finally took him to an allergist and dermatologist, and they said he was allergic to wheat, milk, eggs, peanuts and tree nuts. And it was devastating and overwhelming, and I knew at that point things were going to be different. We had to change the way we shopped for food, stored our food, and cooked our food. We had to make sure, we started at Whole Foods, getting new, different formula, different baby food. We had to get special container, you know, Tupperware with red lids. Anything with a red lid, that was George's. He had a separate pantry because as he was getting older and he was able to go to the pantry and pull food out, I wanted to make sure he wasn't eating something that would be, you know, hurtful to him. Also, in cooking our food, it was important that we made sure that cross-contamination wasn't a factor. In teaching him how to read labels, he was 2.5, I mean 3. As soon as he could recognize letters, he would be in the shopping cart with me, and I would pull things out and say, can you have this? And he would be looking for the D on there that specified dairy being in a product. He would look for the word egg in the ingredients. He would look for the G word, which would be gluten-free. I mean, he was young, but I just always taught him, like, this is, I taught him as though he was never going to outgrow it, and I felt like I was equipping him with the knowledge to keep himself protected.
Seafood, gluten, eggs, dairy, peanuts, and tree nuts.
It was hard for a little while, until he was about 5, and he was then gonna, like, leave my bubble. He's in a bubble with me. And once he started going to school and leaving that bubble, it was probably harder for me than it was for him. I used to pray for him to outgrow it. And once I realized that might not be a possibility, I started praying for me to be able to handle him going off and doing things. In all other ways, he was a flourishing student. He was a flourishing athlete. He had many friends. He was playing ball all the time with his brother and his cousins, who have truly supported him in that.
I like to play shortstop for baseball. I like to be point guard for basketball. I like to play soccer.
His brother was always very conscious, even himself as a toddler, 4 or 5 years old, knowing exactly what George could eat and couldn't have. He would reinforce the rule. If it doesn't come out of his bag, he wasn't eating it. And as he got older, the rule became, if you can't read it, you can't eat it. I had seen different fears developing in him when he was going to school. And even when he's not in school, he always wanted to be home. He wants to be in his safe place. If we were going to a family party or a friend's party, you know, he would start crying. He wouldn't want to go. And, you know, I think my whole philosophy was like, get your shoes on, let's go. And the one time I sat down and asked him, like, what's the problem? Why, you know, we're going to so-and-so's house. And he started crying and said, why does everything have to be about food? I know there's going to be food there, and he doesn't like to be around food. And I never really thought about it because he really can't have anything that people were giving out. Pizzas, ice creams, cakes, even though my husband and I have become walking refrigerators. We've schlep his ice cream, his cake, you know, his tacos, anything that it is that he could eat. He still was isolated to a certain degree that he was feeling.
Yeah, these are all Georgie's snacks when he heads to a birthday party or family party or a dinner with family. Skittles, he can have, they're gluten-free. He's gonna enjoy life, everything, and enjoy life is free of everything, nuts, dairy, soy. So, enjoy life, everything is good for George. And Starburst, which are his favorite. And Dum Dums, lollipops. So, he has plenty of them when kids are having candy. He can have that. And then we pack his cookies, which are all Enjoy Life chocolate chip. And he has his sugar cookies and his double brown chocolate, which they're double brownie.
Georgie's just like any other kid, except he has allergies. He has about 10 trophies, and he only played about 2 years of sports. He plays out back, and just with my friends. He's probably better than half the kids out there.
Wait, George, on the ball, buddy.
Mom packs his lunch and my lunch, and sometimes I buy lunch. He usually has like chicken nuggets or noodles or something.
I usually have like bacon or like, where I don't have any lunch and I just eat snacks.
She'll bring like a big bag of like cookies, like a couple boxes of cookies, bacon, chicken nuggets, noodles, and like put his pudding and all, drinks, juice boxes, is just for the ride.
It's not the worst thing in the world, but you know, for him it was isolating, so we've just learned to deal with that issue with him. There's hope. He's a normal boy. He just can't eat the processed food that people have eaten. He was born into, you know, this Irish Italian family that lives to eat. Everything is about large. You know, how much more food can you fit on a table? And I have a child who eats to live, and it's okay. It's fine. And he's, you know, flourishing as a child, so he's good.
So. I'm just like everybody else.
Do you want to take a break?